How's it feel to go into the semifinals?
You know, it feels pretty good. It's always nice getting a win from a tough team. I really thought we did a great job as a team, just battling it out.
They moved the ball on you guys pretty well. You know, were able to get up and down the field, get some points, but it seemed like you guys were able to stiffen up and get some stops when you needed at the end of the game. What were you able to do to get those stops when you needed them?
You know, it's really just listening to what the coaches call and executing, and that's all we could really ask for, and that's all we really did.
And did they do anything differently than what you had planned for, than what you were expecting on offense?
So I'm not exactly a big scheme guy, but, you know, I just go out there and do my job.
Fair enough. You did have trouble getting off the field on third downs at times, especially early in the game. What were they able to do to, you know, extend plays, keep converting those third and longs?
You know, we just got to keep the quarterback contained. He got out of the pocket a couple of times, had some good throws, got some good runs, and if we stopped that, then, you know, we'd be good.
Yeah, Caleb, what kind of change? What did you guys talk about a little bit at halftime to maybe kind of change things up a little bit? Was there anything they were doing, anything you guys did? Because they certainly kind of moved it up and down on you in the first half, and you're able to get some bigger stops in the second.
I think it was just more of like a reality check that, you know, these guys are a really good team. And, you know, we just had to come out with better energy than we did in the first half, and I thought we did that, and it helped us execute.
I mean, you knew this playoff run wasn't going to be 31-3 each week. What does this do for the team? Obviously, you still hopefully have two more that you want to get, but what does it do for the team to win a game like this and prove you can kind of come back after some adversity when it's on the line?
I just think it proves that, you know, we can finish. We can go down to the last second if we need to, and like we did today, and that's what we did, and we can do that every week if we need to.
Sure, you don't know anything about Delaware yet, but you'll host them sometime next week. Be probably another national TV game. Just what are your thoughts about getting one more shot to play on this field and a shot to go to the national championship game?
You know, we're all just excited. We have to go out there, do our job, get it done, and hopefully we can move on to Frisco.
Any further questions for Caleb?
Caleb, if I could ask you, I'm from Southern Illinois, and how tough is it, you know, what's the toughest part about when SIU's got the ball down on the one-yard line, what's the toughest part about trying to read where the ball's going and getting that big stop?
I mean, as a D lineman, it's not really reading anything. It's just going forward, putting your head down, and trying to push the lineman back, and hopefully someone in the backfield can, you know, make a play.
How much was that a turning point when, you know, they got the ball at the one or the two and you guys were able to stop them on that fourth down with the offensive guard trying to go over the top?
That's huge. You know, it's a big momentum swing. It's something we really needed. We really needed that stop. And once we got it, I think our offense just took over and got the job done.
Jadon, was there any moments of nervousness in this game? Did you guys feel all along like you had it, or how tense did it get down there on the sidelines or in the locker room?
Yeah, there was definitely a little bit of nervousness getting down right away there. But Chris Kroc, our mental strength coach, has done a really good job with us, just keeping us mentally prepared, mentally strong, you know, to stay positive throughout the game. And we knew that we had a chance to win it, so we just had to go out and execute and make the plays, and we did.
It looked like you were going to go into halftime down 20-7. And they'd score 20 points in a row. Then you get the big kick return from Isaiah and turn it into a field goal. It was just 3 points. You're still down 20-10. But how important was that to kind of, you know, maybe give you a little bit of momentum going into halftime?
Yeah, that was super important. We didn't really have much momentum at all right there. And just kind of going out there in 20 seconds, like you said, and getting a field goal was a big momentum swing going into halftime. So we came out fired up in the second half and just executed better and got the job done, for sure.
Jadon, what was this like, especially as a South Dakota boy, to be playing on national TV and winning a game in this fashion?
Yeah, this was probably for a game, this was probably the craziest moment so far in my lifetime, especially being from South Dakota and playing for the Jackrabbits. It was a dream come true signing here 3 years ago, and just been working my butt off and it's finally my time. I stepped up and just making the most of my opportunities.
You also probably know that this is a fan base, kind of like a certain NFL team in Minneapolis that's...
That you get a few punches in the gut in playoff time and maybe look like it's going to be another one. What about this team that makes it different and allows maybe the special team to break through?
So a lot of the guys on our team were part of the starters last year when we beat UNI, and then in the playoffs we lost to them. So we did everything we could this week to make sure that that didn't happen again. We beat SIU pretty bad earlier in the season, and we knew we could do it again, but we didn't want to overlook them, and we just made sure that we executed and gave them the respect that they deserve.
I know you don't know anything about Delaware yet, but they're the only four teams to buy the national TV games, came again. Again, using that hometown tie for both you, your brother, and the other kids on this roster, how much more does this mean to have a chance to play for go to the national championship on your home field?
Yeah, this means everything to us. Preston Tetzeloff, our lone senior. These last couple weeks, we've just been saying that this could be his last game, so we all just go out there and play for him. And Preston is probably one of the greatest guys you'll ever meet. He's a true jackrabbit, and we're just kind of dedicating these last couple games to him.
Mark, congratulations. You guys haven't had to play from behind a lot this year, and your offense, frankly, isn't really built to play from behind. When you guys found yourselves down and in a little bit of a funk offensively, what did you say? What did you talk about? What did you do to kind of try and snap out of it and get going?
We knew things weren't working in the first half, and we just needed to get back to just playing our game, playing our style of game, getting a little bit more in the quarterback run game, really just being downhill runners, and then also just taking some shots too. Really just helped us start getting back into a groove and start building some more confidence and really just start putting drives together and start putting up points.
Was there anything that happened or that anyone said to you that kind of, not suggesting you were rattled or anything, but that kind of got you back on track at some point? I mean, you individually?
I just got to say that I just have a bunch of guys that are all around me that support me through and through, no matter what's going on the field, no matter if we're going through adversity. And it's just great to be with a group of guys just on the field that are just excited and just have my back no matter what.
How much do you think going through that adversity, winning a game today the way you did, can help you going forward?
It really just helps us showing that, like, we can do it no matter what. Even if we're behind by 10, 13, 10, 2 touchdowns, 3 touchdowns, like, as long as we just continue to be us and just stay confident that we can do anything, really.
How big was the kick return and field goal before halftime?
That was huge. That really got us – that built a lot of confidence for us. Going into the second half, put a little juice and really felt like we can do this, we can make this comeback, and this game is ours, basically.
Mark, I know you guys had the loss earlier this year at UND, but this is essentially kind of the biggest gut check moment of the year when you're getting beat 20-7 and they were kind of dominating. What kind of came out of the scene maybe at halftime that – I know you got that field goal that kind of turned some things too, but kind of came out of the scene at halftime that – helped you really turn this thing around with everything on the line?
Going back to that UND game, I mean, in the second half, I felt like we were just trying to be more of just heroes and trying to play by ourselves and really weren't playing as a team and playing as a full unit. And then this second half, I felt like we were really together as a team and really just tried to just play our game and just try to finish every play, go 1-0. And it showed. And, I mean, as we kept on playing, we kept on getting some more confidence and our defense kept making stops. So I felt like just that confidence just in the second half just really helped us.
I don't know how much you saw of the Jackrabbits when they had Goddard and Winicky and Christian, but this used to be a team that passed a lot, really kind of relied on that. This is a physical run team now. When you guys get it going like that, you feel like what does that feel like when you guys know you kind of have that edge between the three of you, between you three backs, essentially?
I mean, I really got to give it up to our linemen, first of all. I mean, they're just a great group of guys that are always just working 100%, giving all their effort every single play, even in practice, even any drills. And they really just give us the push every single time. I mean, they're pushing any defensive line off the ball at least 3 yards, and it just makes it easier for us to bounce it out, get bigger plays, just hit the holes, and basically just do it from there.
Last thing I was going to ask, I know we kind of made a lot about the late kickoff being an issue tonight, but a national TV game – crowd you had certainly felt into it. What did you think of that, and what do you think about the opportunity to probably play one more national TV game next week against Delaware?
It was unbelievable. It was just really exciting to have an opportunity like this and just being able to play in front of all these people and having a nationally televised game here at home. I mean, we've been playing night games before, so we were ready for that, but just having this opportunity to just to play under the lights again at home really is just unbelievable and awesome.
Mark, can you talk about what you saw on that 67-yard touchdown run? Looks like you broke a tackle right by the line of scrimmage and was kind of off to the races after that.
Yeah, I think it was one of our linemen just came around, made a great block on one of their linebackers, and basically just had one guy to beat, broke that tackle, and it was off to the races there, and I just had to keep going as fast as I could and keep my feet high, keep my knees high, and not get tripped up at the end.
How big a lift was that your team to put you guys ahead for the last time pretty much that game?
I mean, that instilled a lot of confidence in our offense and a lot of confidence in our defense as well, knowing that, like, we have their backs no matter what and that they can go out and make plays as well. And then the game was in our hands at that point, so we just had to go be us and continue from there.
Thank you.
Mark, there's a lot of pressure involved in these games. You know, we're getting down to the Final Four now, and I'm sure you guys saw on TV today, you know, North Dakota State got beat. Jacksonville State got beat. When you see those upsets, does that increase the pressure? I mean, so many people are expecting you to get to Frisco. How do you feel like you guys are handling those expectations?
I feel like that we're handling these expectations amazing, actually. And one thing that my dad has always taught me and just said to me as I was growing up is never let the pressure exceed the pleasure. And really just enjoying every single moment that you have out on the field, never letting that pressure really try and get to you and just try to have fun out there. And winning is fun, so we just keep doing that and keep having fun, really.